Welcome, everybody. And so, without waiting any further, we will begin this group meditation together. And if it's not already the case, simply relax. Take a comfortable posture. And if it was gone somewhere for a little while, you can hang a smile on your face again. Whatever the reason, doesn't matter. We're not here to judge. Just to smile. Do a bit of a cleanup in body tension. Simply wash away all of the tensed areas that you might feel. Anywhere in your body, but also perhaps around your head, around your brain. There might be some tensions there. Just smile, see what that does. And relax. Letting go of all external stimuli. That is the first step of the Buddha's meditation. And letting go of any kind of restlessness or anxiety or fear or anger. Whether you've been working with forgiveness, whether you've been working with any of the Brahma-viharas, these are wonderful tools to overcome these hindrances and recondition the mind for it to be very wholesome. And letting go, relaxing of the distractions and the tensions. We notice this feels good. This feels like relief. There is a goodness to it. This is what we call pamoja. Relief, gladness. Finally, we can just disengage from all of it and smile. Viveka jang piti sukhang. The blissful ease that comes from letting it all go. And this can always be done with metta, with karuna, with mudita, with upekkha, love, compassion, joy, or calm. Since most of us will be working with loving kindness, we can develop this understanding of how the mind works and goes through each of the levels of meditation. As it calms down, using love as a vehicle, perhaps some words are helpful. Like, may all beings be happy. Or, I love you. Not necessarily to one particular person, but to all of them, to life. This is called Sāvitakkha Sāvicāraṁ, with thinking. with some kind of imagining still. This is called the first level of understanding or meditation. The first jhana. Always with a smile. This is a smiling meditation. Even if we don't believe in it, even if it feels faked. Many people experience this at the beginning, but as we persevere and bring up the smile over and over again, the mind is bound to become uplifted. And as the feeling of love becomes a bit more steady, easier to maintain, we might notice that constantly bringing up some kind of thoughts or objects or imagination is too coarse, too heavy for the mind. It feels better just with the metta itself, without anything else. And that feels better. Vitakka vichara vupassama. And the thinking, reflection, calm down. They fade away. Ajatang sampasadanam. And things calm down. The mind becomes much more calm. And collected, unified. Cetaso ekodi bhavan. And there is great bliss and ease with this newly come collectedness. Samadhi jang piti sukham. And this is what we call the second level of meditation. When things calm down, the mind calms down, the thinking goes away, and there is great bliss that comes from collectedness of mind. Metta is a way of being, a way of living. Not only meditation. And we must be strong and determined, devoted. Thinking that whatever mind will come up with, we will love. Whatever external situation is, we will welcome it with love, accept it, wish for these people or for our own mind peace, goodness, harmony, and this is how we will get to experience it as well. Very often, the second or the third day, there will be a little bit of a dip in the meditation. And this happens for a lot of people. And as we continue practicing, not taking the mind so seriously, this so serious mind, is it really for our own good? No. Taking everything personal, having so many judgments against ourselves, against others. What about we just let it go? Forgive. That kind of mind is lost. It has forgotten what is good. Doubt, worrying. Criticizing ourselves. Questioning. Poor mind. May it be happy. May it find peace. And is it really you? Did you ask yourself, oh, I haven't worried for a long time, I should do it now? No. It just comes up because it's an impression on the mind. It was built in somehow, and now it comes up. Nobody wakes up in the morning thinking, oh, I feel like worrying today. That just doesn't happen. But it still happens, and people still worry. They get caught. They think it's them. It's just a mental conditioning. When, how, I don't know. It doesn't matter. It's a conditioning. It comes up. We let it go. Is it really you? Did you order it? No. This we will slowly start to understand. All of these distractions that arise in our mind. Is that really us? Do we really ask for these things? No. This is what we call bhava, a force that was accumulated over a long period of time. And these things, they don't stop one second right away. And here we slow down, cultivate wholesome states, and these things become very, very apparent. And that is our very precious opportunity to finally deal with them, to see them, see what's under the surface, and to shine it out with love, and to reprogram. We are the masters of our own destiny. We have the choice. These impressions, we have developed them. We can also undevelop them and develop wholesome impressions. And this is what we are doing. Learn to laugh at your mind. That will take away all of its power when it gets too serious or too dark. Oh, here goes mind again. Really taking itself so seriously. Smile, laugh. It's the monkey mind. Remember that harder times, or bigger distractions, or these walls that we hit. They're actually a good thing. These are the things that are inside, and they're coming up. And now we're dealing with it. And once we deal with them, our meditation becomes much better, and you will see so many people experience it. And when it's hard for you, have compassion for yourself, for your own mind. This will address the hard time without leaving the meditation one bit. If you can't love, forgive yourself for not being able to love. If you can't smile, forgive yourself for not being able to smile right now. If tears come, let them come. It doesn't matter. This meditation, we can't carry rocks in our heart. We have to be free. We have to empty our bag. That is why this meditation is so precious and unique. And afterwards, we will feel much more uplifted. So much lighter, it will be easy to meditate. This meditation is the end of suppressing and repressing things. Now we have to accept them, to look at them straight in the eyes. And have compassion and love for them. And we fill up on joy, we fill up on love. And we let go of everything else. everybody here as all the faculties necessary to make big progress in their meditation. And to experience the goal of this teaching. Continue practicing. Never give up. And this is how you will make great progress. And you will reap great fruits. Continue smiling all the time. Laugh at the mind when it becomes too serious. And devote yourself to love and forgiveness. And your mind is bound to experience wonderful progress. Bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkhantu sabba devata sabba buddhanu bhavena sada sati bhavantu te bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkhantu sabba devata sabba dhammanu bhavena sada sati bhavantu te Bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkhantu sabba devata sabba sanghanu bhavena sada sati bhavantu te. May all blessings be with you, and may all the devas protect you by the powers of all of the Buddhas, the Dhamma, and the Sangha. May you be well and happy. Sada.